our favorite recurring segment that's been recurring for what, like 1.5 months at this point?
I love it.
I think that's the longest running segment we've ever had.
Yes, it is.
It's My Immortal. Seriously, do you remember what happened in our last episode of My Immortal? We are so close to the end. We've got something like 14 chapters left, which is the size of a short middle school essay.
Exactly. Yes. All right. So Ebony, Dementia, Darkness, Raven, Way, named after Gerard Way, but not related to Gerard Way, the lead singer of My Chemical Romance.
I think it's Ebony, Darkness, Dementia, Raven, Way.
What did I say?
You said Ebony, Dementia, Darkness.
Oh, excuse me. All right. So anyway, she had a vision that Harry Potter and Draco Malfoy's dads had been shot to death by some sort of writhing, ichor, black tar monster. Like, the absence of light itself had killed them. So she went to Dumbledore and was like, you gotta fucking find these two guys before they fucking die. And Dumbledore did. Dumbledore sent out a bunch of agents. They were brought back to Hogwarts, and a big party was being thrown for Ebony for having rescued Harry Potter's godfather and Draco Malfoy's father.
Oh, yeah. Didn't they drag them into a dorm room on a stretcher?
Yeah, exactly. It was weird. They were in a stretcher. The party was gothic themed. There was like a red and black cake. All of the Britneys had like hymn tattoos on their hands because like everybody wants to be goth now because everybody loves Ebony because she's so cool. But Ebony didn't want to be the center of attention, especially given the mission that she was just put on.
Yeah, she was just tasked with, she has to go back in time and fuck fuck Wizard Hitler.
And fuck the incel out of Voldemort. Because if she can do that, Voldemort will fall in love in the past and won't grow up to be such a bad dude. And so she was given a time turner by Professor Sinister.
Sinister, okay. I thought, because I was remembering her as Professor Sinatra, but I guess that's probably due to a spelling error.
Yeah, and I don't know. I remember there being like a cool professor in the Harry Potter books, but I don't remember their name. Anyway, Professor Sinister is half Japanese, something we were told immediately, because according to the author of My Immortal, Japanese equals cool. Just like Sriracha thinks.
Exactly. Weeaboo Nation.
And the very last thing that happened was Ebony, Draco, and Vampire, who's actually Harry Potter, all hid under Vampire's invisibility cloak to sneak away from the party.
And that brings us back to chapter 28. We went into a black room. The walls were black with portraits of gothic bands like MCR, Good Charlotte, and Marilyn Manson all over them. A big black coffin was in the middle. Red velvet lined the black box. There were three chairs made of bones with real skulls on them. I was wearing a black corset.
I forgot about this.
I was wearing a black corset bar with bra with purple stuff on it, fishnets, suckings, and a black leather thing underneath. I sat down on one of the chairs dispersedly. So did Draco and Vampire. Are you okay? Vampire asked, putting his alabastered hand on my...
Alabastered?
Yeah.
That's what it says?
Yeah, it's like the word mixed between bastard and Alabama.
That's great.
Putting his alabastered hand on mine, he was wearing black nail polish. I was wearing black nail polish with red crosses on it. Yeah, I guess, I said sadly. Draco also put his hands on mine sexily. I smiled sadly with my black lipstick. The problem is, I have to seduce Voldemort. I have to go back in time. Draco started to cry sadly. Vampire hugged him. It's okay, Ebony, he said. But what about me? You're not going to break off or anything, are you? Of course not, I gasped. Really? He asked. Sure, I said. We Frenched sexily. Vampire looked at us longingly. Then I took off Draco's MCR t-shirt and seductively took off his pants. He was hung like a stallion. Like a Stallone. He had replaced the vampire tattoo that said Ebony on it. Black roses were around it. I gasped. He looked exactly like Gerard Way. Vampire took a video camera. I had said it was okay before. So Vampire was planning on cucking, or Draco was planning on cucking Vampire ahead of time.
No, this is, it's good to have a plan. This is something I learned from Loveline. If you're going to do a threesome or something, everybody meet up beforehand, talk about what's cool, set some ground rules, come up with like a little run of show. Like, you two start kissing, then we'll kiss, then the three of us will kiss, then these guys will go down on each other. Like, it's good to, you don't want to just be improvising in the middle of it.
Sounds incredibly sexy, having a roster of who's kissing who in the middle of the three-way.
Look, what you lose in the spontaneity, you more than make up for in emotional intelligence. Everyone's on the same page, everyone's more comfortable. That's my sex tip of the day.
I'm just imagining it as like a choreographed dance. Like, have you ever watched the artistic swimming?
No.
In the Olympics? Oh, well, it's really cool. You should watch it.
Okay.
I took off my clothes. Then we were in for the ride of our life.
Wait, they're all going back in time?
No, I think they're talking about fucking.
Oh, okay. But oh, they're still having sex.
But
okay.
This is the poorest written sentence, I think, in this entire. It took me, what, two starts? And I don't think that's the weed gummies either. This, okay.
Try one more time.
I took off my clothes. Then we were in for da rid of her. R, the letter R, lift.
Okay, that's real bad.
That's worse than usual. We started Frenching as we climbed into the coffin. He put his Spock in my you-know-what, and passively we did it. I love you, Ebbleby. Oh, let me feel you. I need to feel you, he screamed as we got an orgasm. We watched Vampire filmed everything perfectly. Suddenly...
I'm glad the cinematography was to their liking.
I mean, who's that for? It's not for the internet, it's for you.
I mean, yeah, but how does she know it was all filmed perfectly?
I mean, maybe he was filming it with the camera thing. You know how cameras have a little screen? Oh,
they can turn this little screen around.
You can flip it so you can watch. It's like that scene from American Psycho where instead of fucking himself in the mirror, she's like fucking herself in the rear view finder of the camera. I love you, Ebbleby. Oh, let me feel you. I need to feel you, he screamed as we got an orgasm. We watched Vampire filmed everything perfectly. Suddenly, dot, 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 what the fuck are you doing? It was Snope and Professor McGonagall. I think this is the second time that they walked in on them fucking.
This is the second time McGonagall has seen it, and this is the third or fourth time Snape.
Yeah, like just having semi-public sex, I guess.
Well, wait, what room is this? Because it's a dark room with, like, a coffin and skull chairs. Like, I thought that that was, like, the time travel room or something.
Oh, I don't think so.
Okay, I guess this is the Hogwarts fuckatorium, and McGonagall and Snap wanted to use it.
Chapter 29, author's note. Shut the fuck up. You're just jealous because you're preps, so fuck you, Raven, you rock, girl. Thanks for the help. MCR rock 666. Oh, my Satan, we screamed as we jumped out of the coffin. Snap and McGonagall started to shoot at us angrily. Come now, Preacher McGonagall yelled. We did guiltily. We left the room, putting on our clothes. Snoop grabbed the caramel and put it in his pocket. I guess it means camera.
There we go.
She's confiscating the sex tape.
I did not. I was confused until you said that.
Hey, what the fuck? Vampire shouted angrily. Yeah, Buster, what the fuck are you going to do with that fucking camera? Draco demanded, all protective, looking at me longingly with his gothic red eyes. Look, Dumbledore knows your little secret, and if you do this again, then you go to St. Mango's. So give me back the caramel. Ha ha ha. The mystery of magic thinks he is crazy. There is no way Day will believe him. Snoop laughed meanly. Yes, so shut your mouth, you insolent fools, yelled McGonagall. She made us come into a weird room with white stones all around it. There were all these weird tools in it. Draco started to cry, all sexy and sexitive. Get like sensitive, but sexy. Like a intergaging. Like, what do you call a boy who's sensitive and sexy?
Sexitive. Yeah. That's what they call me, Stereo's Coconut.
Nathan should have. Do you think Nathan read this and then took inspiration from it?
Well, I mean, this is so terribly written that I think Nathan might have written this.
Get it? Because he's a sex bomb. Lol, Tom Fennell rules for life, but not as much as Gerard. You're sex on legs. I love you. You fucking rock. Marry me. I started to cry tears of blood. In parentheses, it happens in Vampire Chronicles. Raven said so. So, okay, fuck you.
Well, if it happened in the Vampire Chronicles, it must be a real thing.
Vampire Meyer took out a black handkerchief and started to wipe my red eyes. And then he and Snoop took out guns using magic. They started to shoot each other angrily. None of the bullets good on each other yet. I took out my wand. Crossio, I shouted. Snap started to scream. He dropped a gun. But it was too late. Both of them have run out of ballots. I stopped to curse. Professor McGoggle did a spell so that they were all chained up. She took out a box of tools. Then she said, okay, Cerberus, I'm going to go now. She left. Snape started to laugh evilly. Vampire started to cry. It's okay, N.O.B., said Draco. Evergreen will be all right. Remember this video you took of Snake? Snake laughed again. And then he took out some whips. The end of chapter 29.
What is happening?
What is going
on? I'm so confused. Okay, look, I had put this little thing together in my head, and I'm realizing now how wrong I was. I was like, okay, goths don't like parties, so they're trying to sneak away from the party. That's kind of like a classic, also like a classic, like hero's move in storytelling.
Right,
like,
okay.
The hero doesn't want to be celebrated. They did the right thing because they did the right thing. And so I kind of figured they would just go to fuck before she went back in time, like a goodbye fuck. But now they're being tortured by Snape and McGonagall. Doesn't everybody have bigger problems to deal with than like three teenagers fucking at this school?
Yeah, it's like, oh my god, this is a major point of contention in this school. Is no one else, is everybody else asexual? Like, you can't tell me there are no other pairs of students they're fucking that you can go bother for once, because it feels like they get caught fucking every time they fuck.
Yeah, and Snape and Lupin were fucking just in the hallways of the dormitory, so it's fine when they do it. This is so fucking confused. Also, why does McGonagall care? Like, I don't know what McGonagall's motivation is here.
Are you saying that because she's not a Slytherin?
No, I'm saying it because it's like, all right, so McGonagall was like, all right, Snape, I'll help you tie them up, and then I'm going to leave? Like, I'd get it if McGonagall wanted to torture some kids. And I'd get it if, like, McGonagall wanted to, like, watch some people fuck, but it's like, I guess she's just doing Snape a solid. Well, why couldn't Lupin have done this too?
Maybe Lupin is still at St. Mango. Oh wait, no.
No,
Lupin,
they're both out of St. Mango's.
Yeah, because they were fucking. I remember in the hallway. I don't know where Lupin went. Maybe he went back to St. Mango's.
It's just a weird use of McGonagall. All right, but please continue.
Chapter 30. Author's note, stop flaming the story, okay? You don't know what's even gonna happen.
I don't. I was just flaming the story. You know what? She's right.
So. Fuck you, Asterios. If you flam, you will be a prep so all flamers can kiss my ass. Sorry for saying Alzheimer's is dangerous, but that's the mystery's opening because society basically sucks.
She's just holding a mirror up to society with her jokes about Alzheimer's. She's the first ever satirist.
This is satire, yeah.
Yeah, it's satire.
Because society basically sucks. Fangs to Raven, you rock, bitch. Yeah, I'm going to use that now. Whatever I do say. Like, why do you use the C word so often? Because society basically sucks.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
No, we screamed sadly. Snap started loofing meanly. He took out a camera evilly. Then he came towards Draco. He took some stones out of his pocket. He put the stones around Draco and lit a candle. What the fuck are you doing? I shouted angrily. Snoop laughed meanly. He pulled down his pants. I gasped. There was a dark mark on his you-know-what.
Okay, do you know what a dark mark is?
No.
All right. A dark mark means you're like a follower of Voldemort. Imagine if you had like a swastika tattoo.
Okay.
Yeah, like I think when you join Voldemort, you get a dark mark. That's it.
And
all right.
Voldemort chose to put this one. Okay, does Voldemort control where the dark marks are? Or was Snape like, yeah, I want it on my cock?
I genuinely don't remember. And let me tell you, I've been getting a couple of these Harry Potter facts wrong recently. People are calling me out for it. So I don't know.
See, it's not easy to recount the plot of something instantaneously that you saw 15 years ago.
It is not. Remember the dog father remark? Where Tara called the Sirius the dog father?
Yes, I saw that comment. Isn't Harry Potter's godfather a dog?
Yeah, apparently Harry Potter's godfather, I forgot about this, is an animagus, and he has the ability to transform into a dog. Making that dog father joke really funny, actually. And instead of Sirius, at one point she called him Cerebus, who's a big magic dog. That's another good joke.
Oh, good job, Ebony. You really... Oh, wait, no, Tara.
Tara.
Your name is... there was another one. Somebody messaged me and said that they thought... You remember the heroin cabinet?
Yeah.
Somebody thought that they were saying he pulled out a heroin tablet, crushed it, and then handed it to her to snort.
Okay. I genuinely don't know if heroin comes in tablets. I don't know. I thought it came in little baggies. Maybe it does. I mean, a tablet's a lot more convenient to travel with. You can put a tablet in your pocket.
Yeah, if anybody knows how you ingest heroin from, if it is possible to ingest heroin from a tablet, please call in and leave a voicemail.
Let us know. That makes sense, though. Oh, I read a couple of sentences of My Immortal between episodes. And at one point, she spelled the word but. Like B-U-T-T. And I'm like, I like this girl a lot. She's just putting the word butt in there for no reason when it's not a joke, just for fun.
Oh, yeah, no. And every time she says the word cum, it is spelled like cum.
Really?
Yes.
This girl's great. This is the thing. It's like, apparently her live journal was also written exactly like this.
Really?
So this girl has just found a way to make all these jokes just flow out normal. I don't think she goes back and like replaces the cum with cum and the butt with butt and the K with K and the C with C. She's just like figured out a way to like have that flow out of her like a jazz musician.
I mean, I guess if you practice your craft enough on MySpace, I almost said Minecraft.
Yeah, you did almost say Minecraft.
You can pull out the goth speak whenever you want.
I genuinely think this author is cool. I know that there's some confusion and I got to do a little more research into it, into like who actually wrote this. Like people are claiming they wrote it, but then we don't know if there's proof. I really want to talk to Raven most of all.
Yeah.
Like everyone's looking for Tara. I get the sense that Raven is like the secret sauce that makes this car go.
I bet Raven has some tales to tell. Yeah. About Tara and her seemingly, what's it called, like iron fist that she rules this text with.
Yeah, I know. Like, I want to be like, Raven, that one time you couldn't help Tara and Tara freaked out of you. How did that make you feel?
Especially when she had your dead body get fucked by an adult.
Yeah, exactly. What the hell?
He waved his wand and a knife came. He gave the knife to me. You must stab vampire, he said to me.
Oh, now this is making sense. All right. I was wrong. She was heading somewhere. I should have stopped flamming.
You flammed prematurely. Because if you don't, then I'll rape Draco. No, you fucked it.
No. No, we're not just going to... They've raised the stakes yet again.
I mean, clearly the threat of killing Draco was not enough. She didn't do it. So now he's got to threaten to rape Draco.
This is the second time that Draco has been exposed to sexual violence. Or the threat of sexual violence. I feel so bad for Draco.
Yeah, damn. No, you fucking bastard, I yelled. But then Draco looked at me sadly with his evil gothic red eyes that looked so desperate and sexy. He looked exactly like a pentagram. LOL, get it? Because I'm a Satanist. A pentagram between Kurt Cobain and Gerard. But then I looked at Vampire and he looked too so smexy too. With his gothic black hair, I thought of the time when we screwed and... I did it with Draco and Dumbledore came and tame when Draco almost committed suicide and Vampire was so supportive. Is this really the time to be having this fucking love triangle?
It's look, when something's hot, something's hot. You can't control it. She's looking at these two sexy, tied up, sensitive bi guys. I mean, look, she's going to have some thoughts.
Snape laughed angrily. He started to pray to Voldemort. He started to do an incapitation, dancing around the Stokes, whipping Draco and Vampire. Suddenly, an idea I had. I closed my eyes and using my vampire powers, I sent a telepathic message to Draco and Vampire so they would destruct Snape. Dumbledore will get you, Draco shouted. Yeah, just wait until the mystery finds out, Vampire yelled. Meanwhile, I took out my wand. You ridiculous daughterhead, Snoop yelled. He took off all Draco's clothes just as he was about to rape him. Chrissico, I shitted, pointing my wand.
See? even the word shouted, she's put the word shit into. I unironically like this author. I think she's really cool. One of these characters is about to get sexually assaulted, and she's like, well, this is the perfect time to put the word shit in here as a joke. I shitted.
Crozio, I shitted, pointing my wand. Snoop screamed and started running around the room screaming. Meanwhile, I grabbed my black mobile and sent a text to Sirius. I stopped doing Crozio. What's Crozio?
Crozio is it's like a torture spell. And this is awful because she was doing Crozio before. Remember when Harry Potter and Snape were shooting each other with guns? They magicked. She cast Crozio on Snape. Then Snape was like tortured. Then she stopped Crozio for no reason. And she's just done it for the second time. Just keep the Crozio spell on this guy. He's trying to rape your boyfriend while your other boyfriend's tied up.
I mean, at least she needed a free hand to text Sirius.
You can cast Crozio with one hand and text with the other. Oh, she's a millennial.
I thought you could only, like, you need to devote all your power to it or something. Anyways, I stopped doing Crozio. You dutterhead.
She stopped doing Crozio after she texted Sirius. See?
Maybe he's writhing on the ground in pain. I'm going to kill, shooted Snape, but suddenly Cerberus came. Snape put the whip behind his back. Oh, hello, Cerv. I was just teaching them something. He lied, but suddenly Lucian and Professor Trelawney came in the room. And Day and Sirius unlock the chains and put them around Snape. And then Professor Trelawney says, come on, Ebony, let's go.
Kill Snape! Kill him! Kill this guy! He just threatened to rape your son! Lucian! Lucian, your son is here and was just threatened with rape! Kill Snape! He's causing problems! He's got a dog bark on his dick!
I know, why would they want to leave Snape alive? If they know he's a Voldemort.
Well, look, they might kill him in the next few paragraphs, but I'm just saying, you gotta get rid of this guy.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know about this one, Chief. Chapter 31. I said, shut the fuck up, you quilps. Stop calling Ebony a Mary Sue, okay? You don't even know what's going to happen, okay? Fuck you, Fangs, to my best friend Reagan. This is like, at this point, it's like a computer generator. Yeah, have you seen
this? But the Mary Sue thing is like, you literally call this character Tara at times. If there were ever a Mary Sue, this is a Mary Sue.
I always knew you were on Voldemort's side, you son of a bitch, Sirius said to Snape. No, I'm not. I was teaching them something, Snape claimed. Oh, fucking yeah. I took some black Voldemort re-serum out of my pocket and gave it to Cerberus. He made Snape drink it. He did angrily. Then Lucius took out a tape recorder and started playing it while he did curses on Snape. Then Professor Sinister and Lucian made us get out with them while Snape told his secrets. Lucian told Vampire and Draco... took Vampire and Draco to the nurse after thanking me a million times. Professor Trelawney came to me... took me to a dark room. Now I was going to go back in time to seduce Voldemort.
Now? You can't give this girl a night off? She just witnessed something horrible. Oh, you're going back in time. You can literally, there is no rush to go back in time.
I mean, if she goes back in time now, and she could stop Voldemort from being evil, and then that way nobody would get raped in the first place.
I guess. Can you go back? I mean, you don't have to read it, but like, serum? What was the serum?
Okay, I'm going to spell it for you.
I think it was Voldemort serum, right?
Voldemort serum.
I don't know what that is.
I don't either.
They don't. What does that do?
You want to check the My Immortal Wiki?
I can't. We brought our shitty computer on this vacation with us. It can't record us and open a single Chrome window at the same time.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Yeah, let's just say it's a serum that you give people with dark marks on their cocks and it makes them tell the truth.
I think that he gave him the serum to try to prove that he was a Voldemort follower. Because, like, he didn't want to drink the serum. But, you know, another great way to find out if someone is one of Voldemort's dark thralls is to look for the fucking swastika on their dick. Look for the magic swastika on their goddamn dick that they used to fuck a dog man in the... dormitories.
Yeah, I mean, Ebony's right here. She saw it. She noticed the dark mark on his cock. Couldn't she just say, hey, Lucius, yeah, he's got a dark mark on his cock.
Yes, exactly.
Now I was going to go back in time to seduce Voldemort. Moving posters of MCR and Nirvana were all over.
Nirvana being added to this is new. Have you noticed that? Yeah. Nirvana's only come like, it's like Tara just discovered Nirvana and was like, ooh, this Kurt Cobain, he's super hot. I like him too.
Wait, what the fuck kind of accent is that? What was that?
What? It's a me, Tara Gillespie. I write a book, and I like it to Kurt Cobain, make a pentagram with a Gerard Way, hottest guy ever.
Hottest guy ever, and if you don't think bi guys are sexy, you could get the fuck out, Prem. Hermione, Darkness, and Willow came to... Hermione, I guess it's Hermione now.
Sure, okay.
Darkness and Willow came to... Bloody Mary gave me a black bag from Tom Ridd's store. What's in the bag? I asked Professor Trevlor. You will see, she said. I opened a bag. It was a sexy, tight, low-cut, black leather gothic dress. It had red corset stuff, and there was a slit up the leg. I put it on. My friends helped me put on black fitness and black pointy boots Willow had chosen. Willow and Darkness helped me put on black eyeliner and blood red lipstick. You look fucking kawaii, bitch, Bloody Mary said. Thanks, I said. Okay, now you're going to go back in time, said Professor Sinister. You will have to do it in a few sessions. She gave me a black gun. I put it in a strap on my fishnets like in Resident Evil. Then she gave me a black time tuner. After an hour, use the tuner to get back here, Professor Trevoy says. Then she said, Bloody Mary put a pensive in front of me. Everyone went in front of it. Good luck, everyone shouted. Darkness and Willow gave me... Death's touch sin.
What?
Darkness and Willow gave me Death's touch sin.
I don't know.
DETH'STOUCHSIN. Any guesses?
I just don't know what it means. I don't know what it means. Giving someone the death touch is bad. No, don't give anyone the death touch, listeners. The five finger death touch, don't do it. But in this case, it's good. It seems like it's some sort of emotional support touch.
Yeah, I guess it's, maybe it's that death is good because she's gothic or something.
Maybe. I believe a pensieve is like a... I remember it being some kind of magical device that you can use to view other people's memories, but I don't know why they need it right now.
Oh.
They're just sending her back in time. Sending her back in time looking ready to fuck. Holy moly, what a glow up.
Yeah, could you imagine her teacher being that? Okay, we're sending you back in time, but first, come on, let's a little more cleavage here.
This is a fucked up school. Satanist, now I see why Christians hate Satanists so much. These people are fucked.
Yeah, no, I think I hate Satanists now at this point. Darkness and Willow gave me death touch sin. Then I jumped sexily into defensive. Suddenly, I was in front of the school. In front of me was one of the sexiest goth guys I had ever seen. He was wearing long black hair, kind of like Mikey Way, only black. He had green eyes like Billy Joel Armstrong and pale white skin. He was wearing a black ripped up suit with BAMs. It was Tom Bombadil. Tom Bombadil.
Now again. This is really fucking clever. Because it's supposed to be Tom Riddle, okay? And Tom Riddle is secretly Voldemort. But instead, she's referencing a character from Lord of the Rings that was not in the movies. That was cut out of the movies because he's too fucking ridiculous, named Tom Bombadil, who's like a yellow-booted singing tree man.
I guess it goes to Hogwarts now.
It's just a joke. It's just wordplay for the sake of wordplay. Like, unless this is a tree man, keep going. Let's see if this is a yellow-booted tree man.
How is this wordplay? It's just the wrong name.
Wordplay doesn't have to... Wordplay often doesn't make sense. You know how, like, Cockneys will say, like, go up the apples and pears, which means to go up the stairs.
I've never heard that in my entire
You've never heard Cockney slang?
No.
It makes no sense. Hold on. Let me read you some Cockney slang real quick.
Please do.
I've gone to funkyenglish.com and I've pulled up a Cockney rhyming dictionary. I'm going to read you some words and I want you to tell me what those words actually mean.
Okay. Go ahead.
If I'm like, you're going to be brown bread, governor.
you're gonna be dead.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, sweet. Okay.
Yeah, but you know how like it doesn't make sense. It's like it just kind of sounds the same. Is that wordplay? Is that clever? No, it just kind of rhymes. You're having a bubble.
Excuse me?
It seems like you're having a real bubble over here.
Does that mean like you're having a laugh?
Yes.
You're having a laugh over there?
Because bubble bath, bath, laugh.
You're kidding me. Is that the explanation on here? Oh my God.
Or you read me one.
Okay. China.
Can you give it to me in a sentence?
China.
Give it to me in a sentence.
Hey, China, we going down to the docks today?
China, governor?
No, it means mate. What does that mean?
How does it explain? How does it explain it?
China from China Plate, mate.
See, there you go, exactly. It's rhyming with a word you didn't say.
That makes no sense.
I'm gonna give you one more.
Oh yeah, this is fun. I'm good at this.
All right, it's all going Pete Tong in there. I did.
One more time, friend.
It's all going Pete Tong in there, isn't it? All going Pete Tong.
Uncle Pete Tong. I'm not.
It's
sure.
All gone Pete Tong.
Wrong?
Yes!
Oh!
Time rhymes is wrong!
This is so fucking stupid.
Hey, I got a pain in me loaf. I got a pain in me loaf.
In your ass?
No. In me loaf. You got any Excedrin for the pain in me loaf?
What is that?
Loaf?
Yeah.
Loaf of bread. Bread? Head!
Oh my God.
I've got a pain in my head! I've got a pain in my loaf!
We need to kill all the British people.
Tom Riddle! Tom Bombadil! Wordplay! Wordplay!
Chapter 32, author's note, I said, Noel Fleming, I know his name isn't Tom Bombadil. That was a mistake. If you don't like the story, you can go screw yourself, you suck.
I liked it. I thought it was great. Of course it was. I don't know why she's saying it was a mistake. It was clearly not a mistake. Unless that's her just fucking with people further, which is really fucking funny.
Hi, I said flirtily. I'm Anna B. Way, the new student. I shook my pale hand with their black nail polish with him. De name's Tom, he said, but you can call me Satan. That's my middle name. We shook hands. Well, come on, we have to go upstairs, Satan said. I followed him. Hey, Satan, do you happen to be a fan of Green Day, since MCR and Evanescence don't exist yet?
Nice!
I asked. Oh my fucking God, how did you know? Satan gasped. Actually, I like Good Charlotte a lot, too. Get it? Because Good Charlotte did that song, I Just Want to Live. That sounded really 80s. Oh my God, me too. I replied
happily.
That
doesn't work.
Wait, when does Good
Just
Charlotte...
because you recorded a song that sounds like it was from the 70s, doesn't mean that song was released in the 70s.
I'm not sure what
If that was the case, every Ty Siegel album would have come out in 1962!
I mean, you gotta keep in mind, too, that, like, this was written in something like 2006. So if we're talking about when Voldemort would be a student at Hogwarts, we're talking, like, 1915.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing. It's like, Voldemort is as old as Dumbledore, and Dumbledore is a fucking walking skeleton. So, like, yeah, it didn't happen 20 years ago.
Oh my God, me too, I replied happily. Guess what? They have a concert in Hogsmeade, Satan whispered. Hogsmeade, I asked. Yeah, that's what they used to call it before they became Hogsmeade in the year 2000. He told
said Tom Riddle. Really?
He told me all secretively. And there's a really cool shop called Hot Topic, I finished happily again. No, he frowned confusedly. No, it's called Hot Issue. He smiled. They changed it to Hot Topic in 1998. He moaned.
He moaned? Can you moan that, please?
Hang on. And then in 1998, they changed it to Hot Topic.
I do remember their... Wait, I gotta see if this is correct.
I was
or if this is a Berenstain thing. Because the moment you said Hot Issue, I was like, I kind of remember something called Hot Issue. All right, well, again, showing how convincing this girl is and how wrong I am, I looked up Hot Topic, Hot Issue. Can you guess what website came up first? That's right, the My Immortal Wiki.
You're kidding me?
It came up. It's right here. Differences from the original. In reality, There's no evidence that Hot Topic was ever called Hot Issue. And the company's own website doesn't mention anything about this. Also, while Ebony had her conversation with Satan in 1990, the first Hot Topic store opened in 1998, just 2 years before, and was not in Britain. On top of all this, while some Hot Topics have opened in Canada, there are no known locations in Great Britain. Hence, Ebony most likely could not have gone to any near Hogwarts or Hogsmeade. This wiki, I cannot wait till the story is over. I've been waiting for the end of the story so I can deep dive into this wiki. This, I cannot wait, because I just don't want to be spoiled.
Yeah, no, I love it how the geographic locations of the Hot Topic is the main issue here, not the fact that it was never fucking called the Hot Issue.
Well, no, it's, there could be more than one problem with what's happening here. I mean, another problem is that fucking Voldemort seems to know that Hogwit is at some point called Hogsmeade, which means Voldemort has been to the fucking future. Maybe Voldemort knows that Ebony is a time traveler. Maybe Voldemort is trying to seduce her.
Holy shit, maybe Voldemort is Voldemort from the future.
Maybe Voldemort used a time turner of his own, I'm sorry, a time tuner, to go back in time to kill himself as a kid so that Voldemort could lay this trap for Enobi.
Oh my god, yeah, what if he did that and then he's planning on killing Ebony in the past? That way, I don't know, there's body recognition technology isn't as far along as it is, and he could hide her dead body in the past.
Yeah, the past is the perfect place to hide a murder that happened in the future. Also, Dumbledore said that the only person that could kill Voldemort is Ebony. Ebony, no, you're in danger!
No, Enobi, no! Oh, now everything was making sense for me. So is Dumbledore your principal? I shouted. Uh-huh. He looked at his black nails. I'm in Slytherin. Oh my fucking god, me too, I shrieked. You go to the skull? Get it? Because I'm gothic. Yes. You go to this skull? Oh, school. Skull, school. Do you get it? Because she's gothic.
I do. It seems like you didn't.
I did not. Yeah, that's why I'm swinging with a handicap over here. Yeah, that's why I'm in here. I'm new, I smelled happily. Suddenly, Dumbledore flew in his broomstick and started shredding at us angrily. No trucking into halls. He had short blonde hair and was wearing a polo shirt from American Ogle Outfitters. Stupid goths. Satan rolled his eyes. He's so mean to us goths and punks just because we're in Slytherin and we're not preps. I turned, wow, this is an intergenerational issue.
But Voldemort and Voldemort and Dumbledore were boyfriend and boyfriend. They went to school at the same time. They're supposed to be in the same class.
What?
That's how, I wonder if this girl has read these books. this keeps happening where, like, she just gets basic facts wrong. I feel like someone explained these books to her. She's like, no, I get it. Dark marks. Yeah, they're on your cock, right?
Yeah, she got too high and watched 2 Harry Potter movies and then was like, yeah, this is all the prerequisite information I need.
Yeah, she like has the gist of Harry Potter. well, keep going. Sorry.
I turned around angrily. Actually, I think maybe it's because you're the Bark Lord. What, Bark Lord? Get it? Isn't this the dog guy?
But it's not the dog guy.
Oh.
The dog guy is Sirius Black.
Oh, that's a different person?
Yes. Oh. Sirius Black is Harry Potter's godfather, a.k.a. dog father, Cerebus Black. Cerebus Bark.
What the fuck? He asked angrily. Oh, nothing, I said sweetly. Then suddenly the floor opened. Oh my fucking god, no! I screamed as I fell down. Everyone looked at me weirdly. Hey, where are you going? Satan asked as I fell to the floor. I got out of the hole and it was back in the pensive in Professor Trelawney's classroom. Dumbledore was there. Dumbledore, I think I just met you, I said.
Well, Dumbledore would remember this.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
There you go.
Dumbledore said, trying to be all gothic. Sinister came in. Hey, this is my classroom. Wait, what the fuck? Enobi, what are you, the hell are you doing here? I looked at her. Oh, yeah, I forgot about that. What the fuck? How? I screamed, forgetting she was a teacher for a second. But she's a goth, so it's okay. Professor Sinister looked sad. I was drinking Voldemort serum. She started to cry black tears of depression. Dumbledore didn't know about them. Hey, are you crying tears of blood? He asked curiously, touching a tear. Fuck off, we both said, and Dumbledore took his hand away. Professor Sinister started crying again in her chair, sobbing limpid tears. Oh my fucking god, Annabelle, I think I'm addicted to Voldemort.
We still don't know what it is. This is the second time it's come up as like a major plot device. Here's what we need to know. What it is. What it does. Because if you can become addicted to it, then it's like a drug, right? But then if it's like a drug, which are fun, drugs are based, then why did Snape not want it? Because remember they were forcing it down Snape's throat?
Oh, I know the answer to this.
What?
Okay, so in this hentai I've been watching recently called Redo of Healer, remember I was telling you that? So how they control the healers is they get them addicted to drugs. And then they're like, oh, you don't want to heal our troops? Well, then fuck you. We're not giving you your fucking heroin. So maybe it's something like that. Like, Snape didn't want it because if he did take the drug, then it would become addicted to the drug and he'd, like, start saying, just word vomiting out all of his secrets in hopes of getting more heroin.
I think you just wanted to talk about Addicted to Healing. Wait, what's the name of that show?
Moving right along.
What's the name of the stupid show?
Dig it
Help
up,
Me one. Healer or something?
Yeah, Help Me Healer.
Okay.
Author's note. There's an author's note at the end of this chapter.
What? That's new?
Yeah, I think this is the first one we've seen. See you fucking preps. Go fuck yourselves. That's serious issues. Go to hell.
This is so great.
Voldemort serum, not even once. This is your brain on Voldemort serum.
Goodness great, these are serious issues.
Oh.
You have been doing such a good job of reading this, I have to say.
It's really hurting my brain, because you gotta, like, basically translate it as you're reading.
In real time.
Yeah.
Like, until like, last episode, when you, like, literally spelled out some of these sentences, I had no idea how hard this was. I want to try to read a chapter.
Okay, well, good luck to you.
Yeah, I know. It's just, I think I've learned enough from you at this point to be able to translate this in real time.
I'm ready.
So I will be reading chapter 33, which has no name. All right. Anne. Oh, that must mean author's note.
Yes.
Okay. Anne, colon. I said, shut up. It's not my fault. Okay, if you don't like the story, then you're a prep. So fuck you, Flommers. Exclamation mark, and then the number one a bunch.
Yeah, you gotta just ignore the ones.
P.S. I'm not updating over till you give me 5 good reviews, and this time I mean it. The number one a bunch again. You suck! Thanks, Raven, for die help. I'll promise to help you with your story, lols. Raven has a story, too?
I guess so. I don't know how Enobi could help with that, but...
We gotta find Raven's stories. Oh, my fucking god! Exclamation mark number one. She does this a lot.
Yes, every line, basically.
But she's clearly doing it as a joke.
Yes. Oh, no, I'm not saying that it's not intentional. That was the funniest fucking thing ever in 2007, was to put a whole line of ones after an exclamation point.
I think people don't give Tara enough credit. You know what I mean? Like, she's telling jokes here. I shoot it sadly. Should we get to St. Mangus, bitch? St. Mangus!
Now it's St. Mangus.
Hell no, she said. Listen, Edgergy. I need your help. Next, Tim, you go back in, Tim. Do you think you could ask Tom Anderson for some help? Tom Anderson? Tom Bombadil? Tom Riddle? Tom Anderson!
This is like listening to a sixth grader read from a Spanish textbook for the first time. Like, Va, Playa Raphael?
Tom Anderson must be like the second bass guitarist in MCR or something.
I don't know.
Gotta be a joke. Sure, I said sadly. I went outside the door. Draco was there. He was wearing a big black GC t-shirt, which was his Panamas. Hey, sexy, I said. How'd it go, N.O.B.? He asked in his voice was so sexy and low, kind of like Gerard Way when he's talking.
Can you try that again then? I don't think that line was...
You're right.
...in character.
Oh, I'm sorry. How'd it go, enemy?
Oh, come on. If I can moan out the date that Hot Topic changed its name, you can put a little more effort into this script.
I genuinely was trying. All right. All right. Sexy. But it's like, oh, it's the guy reading it. Yeah. Okay. How'd it go, NOB?
Yeah, there we go.
He asked in his voice, was so sexy and low, kind of like Gerard Way when he's talking. Fine, I responded. We start to go back into the dorm. How far did you go with Satan? Draco asked jealously. So
Draco knows that his name is now Satan?
I guess. Not too far, LOL. I borked. I borked.
Bork.
I barked! She's not a dog!
Yeah, they do a lot of screaming and barking.
Will you have to do it with him? Draco asked angstily. I hop not too far, I shouted angrily. Then I felt bad for shooting at him. I said sorry, we Frenched. What happened to Snipe? I growled.
What happened to Snipe?
You will see.
What?
Draco giggled mistressly. I was trying to do a mistress giggle.
Oh, okay.
You will see.
Ada.
Wait, what's that?
Nothing. Keep going.
Okay. He opened a door. Snap and Lumpkin were there. Sirius was pokering them by staging them with a black knife. No, please. Lumpkin bagged as Sirius started to suck his blood. Lumpkin?
Is this really the best place to stab someone to death? Do you know what's going on here?
No.
Snape and Lupin are being stabbed to death by Cerberus, I believe, who is then going to drink their blood because I assume he is a vampire.
No, he did drink their blood.
Oh, okay.
Okay. I laughed statistically. I took some photons of him and snap being torqued. Okay, I know this is men, but think about it, people. They are pedos. Snap tried to rap them, and anyway, sadistic rock. Has anyone seen Shrek Attack 3? Lols.
I'm gonna do that. I'm having a stroke.
I'm gonna do that one more time. Look, if I had any ideas, I would have given them to you by now. I'm gonna say this one more time. Think about it, people. They are pedos. Okay.
Okay.
There we go. And Snap tried to rape them. Okay. Great.
Pedophiles and also rapist pedophiles.
And anyway, sadist is rock. Has anyone seen Shrek Attack 3 lols? And anyway, sadistus rock?
Can I take a look at that for a second?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. I took some photos of him and Snape being tortured. Okay, I know this is mean, but think about it, people. They are pedos, and Snape tried to rape them. And anyways, Satanist rock. Has anyone seen Shark Attack 3? Satanist or sadist or sadism?
They're both fine, actually. They would both work in this case.
I do not know what Shark Attack 3 is.
Damn it! I was really hoping you know what Shark Attack 3 is. Shark Attack 3 some kind of sadist movie? It doesn't sound like it. It just sounds like a movie where sharks attack people.
I'm going to Google it. Hang on.
Okay.
Shark Attack 3. Shark Attack 3 seems to be a very poorly reviewed horror movie made in the early 2000s.
Does it have anything to do with Satanists or sadists?
Shark Attack 3 Megalodon is the second sequel to Shark Attack, released in 2002, direct to video. The film is notable for featuring John Barrowman, who later found fame in popular shows like Doctor Who and Torchwood. No, there's nothing about Satanism or sadism.
So she just kind of lost the plot at one point, and she was like, oh, Shark Attack 3. Has anyone else seen that? I like that movie.
She's just looking for friends. Leave her alone.
I like her. I'm trying to understand her. I feel like I'm the only person. Look, episodes ago when we started reading this, I was like, it's funny to make fun of someone's bad writing. I now think, as we come to the end of this story, that she's really funny and really smart, and this is a troll, and she is fucking with people. I think she just put that in there just because she thought it'd be funny to fuck with us and have us start asking questions about Shark Attack 3.
I mean, now I want to watch Shark Attack 3, so maybe she's on the marketing team for Shark Attack.
Yeah, maybe this is viral marketing for Shrek Attack 3. We took some of Snipe's blood, then Draco and I went back to our realms. We sat on my gothic black coffin. My clothes were kind of dritty, so I popped on a black leather outfit, funky kind of a leather outfit thingy, kind of like the one Suleen has in Underworld. If you haven't heard of it, then fuck you!
I knew that was coming.
I put on some black platform high heels. Darko, that's funny. Darko put on Desolation Livers by MCR. Then we started to take off each other's clothes.
Why did you just change your outfit if you're just going to take it off immediately afterwards?
No, why do girls put on lingerie before they have sex?
Too fucking Shay. You outsmarted me, Martin Martel.
You can't just wear lingerie all day. It's like all binding and like fucking cuts into your sides and shit.
You familiar with that?
I realized I really sounded like I knew what I was talking about.
Yeah, you did. You did. Well, wait. Sometimes you do that. Sometimes you just say shit so confidently that you clearly have no idea what you're talking about.
It's called being a man, baby. That's why I'm on top of the advertising game.
Remember that time you sat down and you tried to seriously convince me that eggs had a lot of dairy in them? That's why they were triggering your lactose intolerance.
They're in the dairy aisle. They should be a dairy food. If eggs aren't a dairy food, bring them to another aisle!
They're protein. Where are you supposed to put them? They need to be cold.
The frozen pizzas aren't in the dairy aisle. They're in the freezer aisle.
How often do you buy frozen eggs, Asterios?
You know, there's a whole aisle for meat. Put the eggs there. The chicken, is chicken a dairy food?
I don't know.
I'm genuinely asking. I don't know. I really don't understand because cows are at the dairy. So their milk is dairy,
Holy shit.
The meat isn't dairy.
Correct. What is hard to understand?
Then don't call it the dairy. Call it the cowsatorium.
No way refers to beef as a dairy product.
But beef comes from the dairy.
It's not. No, the cows are not the dairy. The milk is the dairy. You fuck. If you milk a goat is not dairy. The milk that comes from the goat is a dairy product.
I understand that milk and meat are different. And milk is dairy and meat is not. Do you understand that cows live at a place called the dairy?
No.
They do. They live at the dairy. But the dairy has non-dairy items at it. Is that not make no sense?
I would bet $5 that a dairy is specifically for cows that produce dairy products, like milk.
All cows produce dairy products.
That's bullshit. No, they don't.
All cows don't produce milk.
Bulls do not.
Bulls aren't cows.
Yeah, but under the umbrella of cow. Every human or every female mammal produces milk.
Yeah. What are we arguing over? You're seriously trying to convince me that there are cows out there that don't make milk. Cows and steers are different things.
Okay. Well, okay. Yeah, but I bet you at the dairy there are no steers there. That's
you know how there's roosters and hens?
Yes.
They're different.
Yeah, but there's roosters on a poultry farm.
Yes, but poultry is roosters and hens. Imagine.
I got you on the ropes now, buddy. You told me the other time we were visiting your parents that you do not eat roosters.
You don't eat them because they don't taste good.
So how's
but they're
poultry?
Still poultry. But here's the thing. Imagine if roosters and hens both lived in a place called the henatorium. And you're like, well, then everything in the henatorium should be a hen, right? No, we have non-hens in the henatorium. Then why don't you just call it a chicken farm?
Did you mean a hen house?
Hens.
The roosters go in the hen house.
Well, they shouldn't.
Oh, now I got you, buddy. Now you're on the ropes.
They shouldn't. You know that's confusing. Why not just call it the chicken house?
They can. You can call it a chicken coop, too, but chickens are not roosters in the same way that cow, the word cow does not encompass steer and cow.
I'm going to say that they probably don't put the roosters and the hens together in the hen house. They probably put the roosters in the rooster house and the hens in the hen house, and they're both on a chicken farm. Because if you put roosters and hens together, they're just fucking all night. All you're hearing is cluck, cluck, clack, clack.
Isn't that the point? Of having a rooster in the first place?
You want them to fuck when you want them to fuck. Not when they want to fuck, because they want to fuck all the time.
Okay, well, fair enough. Welcome back to the Poultry Cast, where we learned about the different types of food groups. You know, when I was a kid, we had a pyramid of cereals. And at the top of the pyramid, we had stuff like oils. And then under that, we had eggs and protein and meat and, you know, protein things. And that's how we differentiated it from the dairy thing, because the dairy had things like milk and cheese and yogurt and, you know, actual dairy products.
Okay. All right. So we agree that milk is a dairy product.
Yes.
All right. Is steak a dairy product?
No.
But they come from the same animal.
Correct.
So you see how that could be a little bit confusing.
No, absolutely not. Okay, Asterios.
I agree with you. I agree with you that eggs are not a dairy product. But can you see why I might have been a little confused, because they're both in the dairy aisle?
Okay, I will concede to you that the fridges that hold eggs and the fridges that hold milk are close to one another.
Why? Then, like, there's steaks over there, there's fish over there. Why put the eggs in the dairy aisle if they're not dairy?
Why do they put butter next to fucking sour cream? I don't know, Asterios. Why is the grocery store designed the way it is?
Those are both fats that are made with milk.
They're both dairy products.
Yes, they're both dairy products, exactly. But eggs aren't a dairy product. Let's get back to the story, goddammit.
Goddammit.
No, Plez, Lumpkin bagged as Sirius started to suck his blood. I laughed and I've already read this. Oh, no. Oh, gross. I talk off his shit and he had a six-pack lols. We started to mock out like in The Grudge. He pot his wetness in my you-know-what sexily. I got an orgy. Oh!
Wait, is she having sex with Draco? Or?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I thought it was Snape.
He put his wetness, his weenus, his penis.
His penis.
In my, you know what, sexily, I got an orgy, an orgasm. Because it's not an orgy, there's only two of them.
Yeah, you're doing
Although when I have sex with someone else, it is an orgy. Because a lot of stuff is happening, I'm just telling you right now.
Okay.
It's a full-on experience.
Where are the fireworks?
Riding Coconut Mountain is like a one-man orgy, baby! Even when I'm in there doing it with myself! That's an orgy!
Amazing.
Oh, Draco! Oh my fucking god, Draco! I screamed passively as he got an eructation. Erection? But they've been having sex.
It's almost like Tara has never had sex before.
I love you, Ta-Ebery. Has he ever said that before? Ta-Ebery?
I don't think so.
Half Tara, half Ebony. This is really funny. She's doing all of this very sushin' on purpose to trigger people. And then she's claiming she's not doing it. He whispered sexily. And then we fell asleep. Lol. You want me to read one more chapter?
Yeah, go for it.
Chapter 34. Author's note. Shut the fuck up, preps. Have you ever read the story? You are probably all just preps and posers, so fuck you! Thanks to Raven for the help. I woke up in the coffin the next day. Draco was gone. I got up and put on a black tight sexy dress that was all ripped at the end. There was red corset stuff going up the front and the back, and it came up to my knees.
Wait, I got a question.
Sure.
Are we in the current time now, or does she need to go back in time again?
She has to go back. You know what? This was explained to us.
Oh, okay.
Professor Sinister said you're going to have to go back in time a couple of times. Remember?
Oh, so is it like dangerous if she stays back there too long or something?
My guess is that the time turner only has like an hour of juice in it. Because remember, like, she was just like talking to Tom Riddle and she just got like pulled into the present.
Gotcha.
There was a slit in the dress like in Mr. and Mr. Symph.
Mr. and Mrs. Smith.
Yeah, but that's not what it says.
I know that's not what it says.
It says Mr. and Mr. It says Mr. and Mr. Signed. Everybody says gay rights.
You're not even trying to read this correctly.
I pot on ripped black fishnets and black stilton boots. Suddenly, Sirius cocked on the door. I opened it. Hi, Ebony, he said. Guess what? You have to come to Professor Sinister's office. Okay, I said in a depressed voice. I had wanted to fuck Draco or maybe listen to MCR or Evanescence.
Yeah, me too.
I came anyway. So what the fuck happened to Snipe and Lupin? I asked Sirius flirtily. Flirtily?
Oh.
He's trying to hook up with this older dog man.
Oh, damn it. She did save his life.
I fucking tortured them, he answered in a statistic way. They are in Azkaban now, lol.
Isn't that, oh, that's wizard jail, right?
Yeah, Azkaban. I laughed evilly. Where are Draco and Vampyra? Vampyra! I muttered. They are excused from school today. Sodomized, moaned sexily. Right now, they are watching The Nightmare Before Christmas. Sodomized. Serious. Sodomized. Why are they talking to each other so sexually? This is just, you know what? That is a good way to dress up exposition. Just have people say everything
just
sexually.
Say everything sexually. Just have your characters moan during the growth.
Isn't that what fucking George R. R. Martin does? Like, if there's an exposition scene, two people will be fucking while they're saying it.
Yeah, you just gotta lay out your battle plans while you're riding cock.
We went into the office. Professor Sinister was there. She was wearing a gothic black dress that was all ripped all over. It kind of like the one Amy Lee wears in this pic. HTTP/, and then there's no URL. It's just an HTTP.
Let's pour one out for Photo Bucket, where it was inevitably hosted.
Oh, no. You want to guess what she's doing, though, Professor Sinister?
Oh, no. Is she masturbating?
She's drinking some Voldemort serum.
No! God damn it. We need to get her to A.
She took out the Pensieve and the Time Torner. NOB, you will have to do another session now. Also, I need you to get me the cure for being addicted. She said, good luck, thanks.
Okay, so she's going back in time to presumably, ostensibly, to have sex with Voldemort, but also now she has to cure addiction?
Well, I mean, if Voldemort created the serum, maybe he has the cure.
How do we know that Voldemort created the serum at this time?
Because it's called Voldemort Serum! That's how we know Voldemort created the serum!
No, I'm not saying, I'm saying like this specific year at Hogwarts. Is that when he's going to create Voldemort Serum? Or maybe she's gonna, does he have the cure to Voldemort Serum? What, I don't know what's going on.
Look, I mean the cure to Voldemort Serum would be to use this time turner, go back in time, and destroy the first ever Voldemort Serum. Because if there is no Voldemort Serum in the past, then you can't get addicted to it in the present.
Yeah, wouldn't that be crazy if she killed Voldemort? Voldemort serum was ever invented, it goes forward and like a Professor Sinister is dead of a heroin overdose or something.
She started taking a much worse drug. Yeah. Heroin from the human world. And then I jumped into the Princiv again. Suddenly, I looked around. I was in the Great Hall eating Count Chocula, which did exist back then. Count Chocula is like a decades old cereal.
Oh, okay, cool.
It was morning, spelled M-O-U-R-N-I-N-G, the most gothic way to spell morning.
As one does.
I was sitting next to Satan. On a table was a tall, gothic man with long black hair, pale skin, pale spelled like bucket and pail, and blue eyes, wearing a suit and black Converse shoes. He looked just like Charlin Manson. I noticed he was drinking a portent. A potion?
Yeah.
Who's he? I asked. Oh, Dad's Professor Slutborn, Satan said. He's the portent's teacher. Ebony? Yeah? I asked. Did you know that Marilyn Mason is playing in Hogsmeade tonight? And they are showing the exercise at the movies before Dad.
Wait. I thought it wasn't Hogsmeade yet. Hogsworth? Well,
but he does know it's Hogsmeade in the future.
But we're not talking to Voldemort. We're talking to the potions professor.
Are we?
Yeah, does the potions professor know the future too? I thought it was Professor Slutblood or whatever.
I'm so confused. Okay, look. Someone... No. Satan is asking this.
Oh.
Satan goes, oh, that's Professor Slutborn. Satan said, he's the portent's teacher. ... Which is an extra long ellipsis.
Oh, okay.
Ebony? Yeah? I asked. Did you know that Marilyn Manson's playing in Hogsmeade tonight and they're showing The Exorcist at the movies before that? Yeah? Says Ebony. Well, a 6-period ellipsis. Want to go to the Contort and the movie with me? Chapter 35. Oh, this has a name. Ghost of You. Author's note. Fangs to Susie for the idea. You rock. Fuck off, preps. Fangs to Raven for to help you rock, girl. P.S. I'm going to end the story. Really, son. So fuck you. Oh, yeah, and if you know any gothic names, please tell me, because I need one for Sirius Fangs. I don't think she means Sirius Black. I think she just means I seriously need a gothic name.
Oh, okay, that's how I interpreted it.
Yeah, okay,
like, I seriously do need a gothic name.
I went into the con men room.
What?
The common room.
Common room, okay.
I went into the con men room, thinking of Satan. Suddenly, I gasped. Draco was there. I grasped. He looked as hot as ever, wearing black leather pants, a black Lonkin Prack t-shirt, and black eyeliner.
Wait. Whoa. Okay. So she's still in the past.
Oh, no, we don't know.
And Draco is here. I mean, she's thinking about Satan.
Oh, no. It's just about to be explained.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay. Draco, what the fuck are you, dong? I gasped. Huh? He asked. Then I remembered. It wasn't Draco. It was Lucan.
Oh, okay. That actually does make sense.
Yes. He still had two arms.
Does his dad only have one arm?
Here's what I think they're implying. That he lost an arm in the attack in the future? Because I don't know. Maybe this character does only have one arm. Maybe he has like a fake magic arm or something that I just don't remember.
I don't know.
Oh, hi, Lucien, I said. I'm Ebony, the new student.
I'm going to fuck your son in the future.
And I'm going to fuck you in the now. We shook hands. Yeah, Satan told me about you, Lucien said. He pinted to a group of sexy gothic guys. They were sitting in a corner cutting. Just sitting in the corner cutting. Just cutting the days away.
It was the 80s.
Some people whittle, some people sew, some people cut, spelled with a K. It was Sirius, Vampire's dad, and Snap! All of them were wearing black eyeliner and black good Shroud band shirts. Listen, I'm in a goth band with those guys, he said. We're playing tonight at the Marilyn Mason show as backup.
Damn.
This next line, I'm going to give it to you exactly how it's written, okay?
Okay, all right, I'll try my best.
Orly, I X'd.
Oh, really? O-R-L-Y?
Yeah, but it's...
Oh, that's a meme.
Yes, but it's all in caps. But then the rest of it's in caps, too. Instead of saying, I asked, I esked. Orly, I esked.
Oh, really?
Oh, really, I esked. Yeah, he said. We're Cloud X Black X Tier X. Three X's in the name of the band. I played to Gutter.
Have you never seen this meme?
No, I've seen it. It's just funny. That she put it in there. But then the whole thing is in caps. But it's not asked, it's X'd. Spartacus plays to drums, he said, pointing to him. Snap plays to boss. And James Potter, Harry Potter's father, plays the guitar to even foe. We call him Samaro after Samara in The Ring, which is a movie that has not come out yet.
It is also not gothic, as we've previously established.
Hey, bastards, I told them. They gave me Death's Touch Sin. Again with this.
Are she trying to say death stares? I have no idea what she's saying.
Maybe. Suddenly, I gasped again. But you don't have a lead singer, I asked. Lucien looked down sadly. We used to, but she did. She contempted suicide by silting her wrists. Oh my fucking god.
No!
That's so fucking sad, I gasped. Oh wait, hold on. Oh my fucking god. That's so fucking sad.
Oh my fucking god, that's so fucking sad.
It's okay, but we need a new lead singer, Samaro said. Well, I said I'm in a bnad myself. Really? Asked Snap. I couldn't believe it. He used to be gothic! Yeah, we're called Bloody Gothic Rose 666. Do you want to hear me sing?
Would you like me to be the replacement goldfish? Who just fucking killed herself?
I'm guessing that's Lily Potter. I'm guessing that's Harry Potter's mom.
Did Lily Potter kill herself?
I don't think so. I mean, they were both killed by Voldemort, I think. They were both killed by Voldemort. But okay. Not in this canon. In this canon, she silted her wrists.
Okay.
Spell without a W. Just R-I-S-T-S. I woke dis empt strit on de boulevard of Brook. Oh! I walked dis empt strit on boulevard of broken drams. I sang sexily. I do not own the lyrics to that song. Everyone gasped. And Puppy, will you join the band, please? Begged Lucien, Semero, Sirius, and snapped. Okay? I shrugged. Are we going to play tonight? Yeah, they said. Okay, I said. But I knew that I had to get a new outfit. I walked outside wondering how I could go forward in time. Suddenly, someone jumped in front of me. It was Morty McFly!
Oh, God, no!
He was wearing a black bad t-shirt and black pajay jeans! What the hell are you doing here? I asked. I will help you go forward in Tim Enderby, he said seriously. Then he took out a black Tim machine. I went into it, and suddenly I was Ford and Tim. That's a pretty good place to stop this week's episode, I think.
Oh, so Marty. So this is now a crossover.
Yes.
Excellent. Yes, I think that's. I've had quite enough of this.
And he took out a black time machine. He did not show her to a black DeLorean, which means that this version of Marty McFly has found a way to, like, miniaturize and portabilize a time machine.
Is that how they go back in the future?
No, in Back to the Future, they have to, like, use a train or a car.
Oh, okay.
Because they have to get up to 88 miles an hour.
Oh, I didn't know.
But they don't now. I guess he's just kind of, I guess they worked that kick out of the flux capacitor.
I mean, how fast could a broom go? I imagine 8 miles per hour.
That would have been a way more exciting scene if they had to get a broom up to 88 miles an hour in the middle of a Quidditch game.
Yeah, that'd be, and then it was an accident, and he accidentally flew forward in time while he was playing Quidditch, and everybody's like, wait, where did Marty go?
Yeah, but, like, just before he did, he put the ball in the hoop or whatever, and, like, scored the winning goal, and then he disappeared. That would be a much better ending, but no, this ending, literally, there's three lines. Line number one, Marty McFly is introduced. Line number two, what the hell are you doing here? Which means that she knows who Marty McFly is, either knows the fictional character or Marty McFly has been a character the whole time, just in the background. I will help you go forward in time, Enemy, says Marty McFly. Meaning he knew about this problem.
No, I mean, this is a lit as fucking interpretation. Instead of being like a weird, geeky high school kid, Marty McFly is like a time wizard.
Yeah, I like the, and he pulled out a black time machine, which means he's gothic
he's
now.
He's a gothic time wizard.
Oh, right, because he was wearing a black band t-shirt and black baggy jeans.
And only goths wear those.
He's not wearing his trademark... He's not even wearing a black version of his trademark puffy vest.
I can't believe it. Wow. I can't believe Marty McFly's a time wizard.
He's gone from prep to goth. Well, listeners, this is chapter 35. We are ending this next time no matter what.
Yeah,
I don't care how long these chapters get. We've got to get to the end of this tale.
We will. And we'll see you next week on The Loudest Podcast. LoudPodcast.com. Bye!
You're so cute.